Hello everyone, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the product interpretation round of the Facebook data scientist interview process, or the Meta data scientist interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a pretty good understanding of what this round is all about, what interviewers filter for and the sort of questions they ask, as well as a couple of tips on how to prepare yourself and for the interview itself. As a quick introduction, I'm from Prepfully. We offer online anonymous mock interviews with someone who's worked in your target company and role. So in this context, we've got a bunch of Facebook data scientists across both their analytics and product teams who've been helping candidates with mock interviews and with advice. They're also the ones who've helped us put together content for this video. Cool, so on to the round then. The Facebook data scientist product interpretation round is one of the four on-site rounds. It happens alongside applied data, technical analysis, and quantitative analysis. So what is this round all about, and what do interviewers typically look for? In this round, you typically get a product case study, and the goal is to see if you can interpret user behavior on a product using data and metrics. You're tasked with figuring out what the right metrics might be to test a certain behavioral hypothesis or hypotheses, and how you'd invalidate these hypotheses and extract insights from the metrics that you decide to go with. Nearly all interview questions in this round take the form of how would you evaluate XYZ. So I'm going to give you five examples to practice against. Example one, what's your favorite Facebook product? How can we improve it? Question two, how would you measure the success of Facebook groups? Question three, how would you determine the success in introducing a new reaction on Facebook? Question four, how would you evaluate the success of YouTube recommendations? And question five, let's say the usage of the birthdays feature has gone down by 17% after a new notification system is deployed. How are you going to investigate this? So in this interview, your interviewer is assessing you across an assortment of topics. The first is, can you demonstrate your understanding of the thinking that goes into a product and the iterations of that product? So what are the trade-offs involved? What are the sort of decisions you make? What are the individual components that could be improved? And so on. The second thing is, can you articulate the hypotheses involved and the metrics you'd use to invalidate or validate these hypotheses? The different metrics say for different product lifecycle stages, for instance, measuring adoption versus engagement. A third, can you design experiments then to test these hypotheses, to test, say, an improvement to retention or an increase in performance? Fourth then is, are you able to interpret these experiments and the results and map them back to your initial hypotheses and the ultimate business goals behind those hypotheses? And fifthly and finally, can you translate these outputs into outcomes, that is, recommendations on what to do or not to do, and can you communicate these with a wider group of stakeholders? All these things are tested to understand how well you can map your data skills into the reality of building a product. So in this context, I have four tips for the interview. First, make sure you're really, really understanding the problem. Think like a product manager in this one. Repeat it in your own words, clarify anything you're unclear about. I simply can't stress this enough. One of the most common mistakes that candidates make is to jump straight into solutions on, hey, I'm success of Facebook groups, I'm going to measure XYZ. You really want to understand what the goal is. You want to scope it. You want to articulate that scope. Explain what your goals are and then define how you're going to attack the problem, because then this also lets your interviewer drive you into the direction they want. Which then brings me to my second tip. Listen very carefully for feedback from your interviewer. They know the scope is potentially infinite. They've got a list of themes they generally like to cover in this interview so that they can assess you across the range of topics that I just talked about. You'll regularly get hints during this, such as, all right, let's assume XYZ isn't a constraint. So this is your cue to move on to the next theme. Or you might be asked specifically for, hey, let's say X goes up but Y goes down. Is there anything else you'd look at? So then this is your cue that they want to see more thinking in this area. So follow the hints, which then ties into my third tip, which is that you'll constantly be coming up with multiple ideas, or at least you should be. And that's a good thing, but you have to be careful because it's really easy to get caught in the rabbit hole of discussing all the potential ideas. What I'd recommend is really practice how to articulate the options succinctly, explain the trade-offs, but then make a deliberate decision and pick one metric, for instance, or pick one hypothesis to test. And practice doing this concisely and effectively with other friends or with colleagues, or practice with a Facebook data scientist. You maybe reach out on LinkedIn or come to Prepfully and book one session with one of them there so that you can get that sort of granular feedback on, are you doing this correctly or not? Finally, fourth and final tip, when answering questions such as this one, always keep Facebook's core values in mind. So move fast, be bold, focus on impact, be open, build social value. And if you see an opportunity to plug these into your answer in an organic way or reinforce how an example you're discussing aligns you particularly strongly with these, don't miss talking about it. This could be, for instance, a way to get a very quick signal, or it could be around challenging an assumption. If you see an opportunity to demonstrate these values even within the interview, take it. So that's basically all from me. This is our guidance from Prepfully, as well as our Facebook data scientist experts on how to rock this particular interview. Once you feel ready for some product interpretation interview practice, or if you just want a sense check of your preparation level, you can always book an anonymous mock interview with a Facebook data scientist on Prepfully. We've got a bunch of them. They're extraordinarily good at getting people into Facebook, so we'd strongly recommend this. I'm also going to link to a bunch of other helpful resources, interview questions, blog posts, a guide, a written guide that goes into a lot more depth, etc., within the description. If you have any follow-up questions about this interview type, please ask in the comments. And if you found this useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.